Good day and welcome to Mission Control Houston, where the team of flight controllers is watching over the activities of the Expedition 33 crew aboard the International Space Station. Space Station currently orbiting about 240 statute miles just off the eastern coast of Canada, heading out over the Atlantic Ocean over cloudy skies. On board, Commander Sunny Williams is continuing to work with her crewmates, which include fellow NASA astronaut Kevin Ford, Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency astronaut Akihiko Hoshide, and Russian Federal Space Agency cosmonauts Yuri Malenchenko, Oleg Novitsky, and Evgeny Tarelkin, as the six crew members get ready for the departure of three of those crew members and the continued operations of the space station with three of the newly arrived crew members. Here in Mission Control Houston, guiding the activities of the team today is Flight Director Tomas Gonzalez-Torres on the second shift of the day. He's working with spacecraft communicator Jay Marschke and a visiting Payload Operations Control Center worker who is here in Mission Control to get some familiarization with how things go here in Houston. With maintenance work completed earlier this week, today is devoted to science experiments, particularly ultrasound data takes. The ultrasound is going to be used part of the integrated cardiovascular experiment, which looks at how the heart relates to long-duration spaceflight. It's also going to be used to look at the human eye as part of an ongoing set of research that looks at how long-term stays in spaceflight affect vision for astronauts. Some of that can be long-term changes to the vision of the astronauts that last after they have returned home to Earth. They're taking advantage of these ultrasound studies of the eye to get more information on that. Williams, Hoshide, and Malenchenko are continuing their departure preparations for the return to Earth a week from Sunday. They have all week to continue working on those activities, while Ford, Novitsky, and Tarelkin are continuing to familiarize themselves with their new home in space. Just to wrap up the week started out with the station completing its 80,000th orbit of the Earth, which is about 2.1 billion miles, or roughly the distance from here to Pluto. And with setups of the integrated cardiovascular experiment work, they also did some troubleshooting for the waste and hygiene compartment toilet that had clogged over the weekend, and were working on their familiarization and departure preparations. Tuesday started on a challenging note with both of the local area network servers on the space station failing. Those laptop servers support non-critical computer activities like messaging, scheduling, and procedure holding. Mission Control was able to perform some workarounds to the schedule so that all of the day's work could be completed, but the crew spent much of Monday morning replacing hard drives so that Mission Control could restore the server software. Additional troubleshooting on the toilet plumbing continued, but Kevin Ford was able to do his first work with the ELITE experiment. That's a European Space Agency investigation that looks at the connections between the brain, visualization, and motions in microgravity. Wednesday was devoted to more plumbing work, but the crew also conducted an emergency equipment familiarization drill to be sure that the new crew members know where all the portable breathing, firefighting, and other emergency equipment are located and how to operate them on orbit, although they received thorough training on the ground before they launched. It's always good to get an on-orbit training session in. On Thursday, the crew finally fixed the toilet by replacing a pre-treatment liquid tank. Kevin Ford actually got his hands dirty doing that plumbing work, good familiarization with the toilet in the U.S. operating segment of the space station before the experiment crew members, the experienced crew members head for home. And that means that two restrooms are now conveniently available to the crew on board the space station. This is recorded video of Kevin Ford doing that last troubleshooting work. Aki Hoshide also had an opportunity to work with the newly arrived JAXA Aquarium, which he performed some collection and freezing of the sample Madaka fish that are being used to study how bones are affected by long stays in space. The Madaka fish, which have skeletons, are good analogs for the human skeleton, and the fact that their lives are much shorter allows more exposure to the microgravity environment from a comparative aspect. And meanwhile, at the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center in Star City, Russia, two of the crew members for the next crew, Roman Romanenko and Chris Hadfield, are conducting additional Soyuz simulation runs today. Hadfield eventually will become the first Canadian commander of the International Space Station. Meanwhile, their crewmate Tom Marshburn is returning to Star City Monday to begin final pre-launch training. The current crew is looking forward to a two-day weekend, but while International Space Station update on NASA television has the day off Monday for the Veterans Day holiday, the station crew will work a full day on Monday. They'll be completing their preparations for the upcoming change of command ceremony on Saturday and the Expedition 33 crew's departure on Sunday. There are several other big-ticket items coming up for the final work for that crew. The advanced resistive exercise device, cable arm rope, and exercise rope are going to be replaced on Monday. There'll be some work on the combined operational load-bearing treadmill, regular six-month maintenance, and some additional work on the local area network planned during the week. There's also some installation of ultrasound background noise sensors on the laboratory. And some additional work on Friday next week with the carbon dioxide removal assembly to check and see if Akio Shide can isolate a small leak that's been noticed in that system that's used to scrub excess carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. NASA TV will provide full coverage of the departure activities beginning on Saturday with the change of command ceremony at 1:15 p.m. Central Time. And then on Sunday, NASA TV will begin its coverage of the actual departure with farewell and hatch closure at 12:45 p.m. That'll be the start of coverage, with the closure expected at 1:10 p.m. Central Time. Undocking coverage starts at 4 p.m. with the undocking planned about 4:26 p.m. Central Time. And then deorbit, burn, and landing coverage begins at 6:30 p.m. with landing expected on the steppe of Kazakhstan at 7:53 p.m. Central Time. On Monday, we'll have a video file on the November the 19th that provides a lot of post-landing coverage and interviews. With the International Space Station now on its 80,060th orbit, this is Mission Control Houston.